A very good morning, dear children. Here I am with another video lecture of English. We have been doing grammar since a long time, and now we are going to take a break from it. And we'll be starting with the topic of reader, chapter 4, that is The Squirrel. The Squirrel is a beautiful poem written by Mildred Bowers Armstrong. Now, what is the special feature of this poem? See, dear children, poets have very keen eyesight. They observe things minutely and then they put it into very beautiful words. This is the best part of poetry. So, if I ask you students the question, have you ever seen a squirrel? So, most of you are going to answer, yes, ma'am, we have seen a squirrel. But if I ask you, have you ever thought of writing a poetry on the same? Then most of you are going to think that it's such a small little cute animal, but we never thought of writing a poetry on it. See, children, Mildred had an idea of writing a poem on the squirrel, and the wonderful facts which he observed about this cute little animal, he has painted them into a beautiful poetry. And we are going to see what he has written and understand it in detail. I hope even you enjoy the poem based on this cute little animal, that is squirrel. So let's get started.
Now we shall take up the explanation of the poem The Squirrel by Mildred Bowers Armstrong. Let's see what are the observations of the poet about this animal. So the poet says, he wore a question mark for tail, an overcoat of grey. If you observe the line, he word has been used. The pronoun he has been used. It means that the poet is personifying the squirrel. And what is the poet saying about the squirrel? That it is wearing a question mark for tail. If you see the tail of squirrel, you observe it carefully, you will notice that it resembles the sign of question mark. And the same is the observation of the poet, and that is why he says that squirrel is wearing a question mark for his tail. Then he starts observing the rest part of the body of the squirrel, and he says that it seems that the squirrel is wearing an overcoat. What is an overcoat? It is a coat which is worn in winter over other clothes. So he says that it seems that the squirrel is wearing a coat also, and underneath he is having his clothes, and above them he is wearing an overcoat which is grey in colour. He sat up straight to eat a nut. He liked to tease and play. So if you have observed a squirrel, it likes eating nuts a lot, and when it is doing so, it is sitting straight. And if you have noticed, if in playgrounds or in parks, when you sit quietly and observe, you will see sometimes on the ground many squirrels are roaming here and there. At times one is running behind the other. At times you will see them running on the branches of the trees. So it seems as if the squirrel is also playing a game, and it is enjoying teasing and playing with its friends. And if we ran around his tree, he went the other way. So if we ran, we word out here is being referred to the poet and people along with the poet. So we can assume that the poet is not alone. Probably he is also having his friends around with him. There are more than one person. So he has used, and if we ran around his tree, he went the other way. So probably the poet and the people who were along with the poet tried to go towards the squirrel to catch it, or maybe to have a look at it closely. So what did the squirrel immediately do? It started running away in the opposite direction. And this is the same observation even you will have if you try to do so. Whenever you try to approach it, try to go near it, it will quickly run away. So this is exactly what the squirrel did. So this was all what the poet had noticed, that how the squirrel looked. It seemed he's wearing a coat, he's having a question mark as his tail. Then he says, what does he like to eat? He discusses that he likes to eat nuts, and even squirrel likes to play. And then how does he behave? Whenever he sees somebody is coming towards him, the squirrel quickly runs away. So this was all about the poem The Squirrel, written by Mildred Bower Armstrong. I hope you are very much clear about this poem. In case of any doubts, we shall discuss it in our online classes. God bless you all, dear children.